Data and information are the assets of today's. In the olden days, people used to gather information from friends and co-workers or classmates. Now, with so-called Google effect, it is certainly convenient to have the sum of all knowledge at our fingertips. Certainly, the access to billions of pages of information on web in microseconds is the easiest thing we can get nowadays. Particularly when there is no direct charge, it seems interesting that providing such service without any cost. But how they do it? Let's check it out. Google LLC is an American multinational technology company that specializes in internet-related services and products, which include online advertising technologies, a search engine, cloud computing, software and hardware. It is considered one of the big five companies in the American information technology industry. Google was founded on September 4, 1998, by Larry Page and Sergey Brin while they were PhD students at Stanford University in California. Together, they own about 14% of its publicly listed shares and control 56% of the stockholder voting power through super voting stock. The company went public through an initial public offering in 2004. In 2015, Google was reorganized as a wholly owned subsidiary of Alphabet Incorporation. Google is Alphabet's largest subsidiary and is a holding company for Alphabet's internet properties and interests. Sundar Pichai was appointed CEO of Google on October 24, 2015, replacing Larry Page, who became the CEO of Alphabet. On December 3, 2019, Pichai also became the CEO of Alphabet. The company's rapid growth since incorporation has included products acquisitions and partnerships beyond Google's core search engine. It offers services like Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides, Gmail, Google Calendar, Google Drive, Google Duo, Google Chat, and Google Meet, Google Translate, Google Maps, Waze, Google Earth, and Street View, Google Podcasts, YouTube, Blogger, Google Keep and Jamboard, Google Photos. The company leads the development of the Android mobile operating system, Google Chrome Web Browser, and Chrome OS. Google has moved increasingly into hardware. From 2010 to 2015, it partnered with major electronics manufacturers in the production of its Google Nexus devices, and it released multiple hardware products in 2016, including the Google Pixel line of smartphones, Google Home Smart Speaker, Google Wi-Fi Mesh Wireless Router. Google has also experimented with becoming an internet carrier with Google Fiber and Google Fi. Google.com is the most visited website worldwide. Several other Google-owned websites also are on the list of most popular websites, including YouTube and Blogger. On the list of most valuable brands, Google is ranked second by Forbes. By 2011, Google was handling approximately 3 billion searches per day. To handle this workload, Google built 11 data centers around the world, with several thousand servers in each. These data centers allowed Google to handle the ever-changing workload more efficiently. Failing Google means stopping the world. The 2020 Google services outages disrupted Google services. One in August that affected Google Drive, another in November affecting YouTube, and a third in December affecting the entire suite of Google applications. Thanks to Google engineers, all three outages were resolved within hours. As a motivation technique, Google uses a policy known as innovation time off, where Google engineers are encouraged to spend 20% of their work time on projects that interest them. Some of Google's services, such as Gmail, Google News, Orkut, and AdSense, originated from these independent endeavors. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe the channel if you find value in this video, and comment down your views about Google.